has a detour in his life. Good Lord, he's taken away. He's disconnected. He's uprooted. Hallelujah. God, why have you uprooted me? God, what's happening in my life? Are the dreams true? Good Lord. Hallelujah. He's trying now whether or not to doubt the dreams he has. Good Lord. But the dreams remain firm in his spirit. Hallelujah. Joseph now got to Egypt, the enemy of God. Good Lord. And when he got down to the enemies of God, Potiphar saw Joseph, bought Joseph, brought him into his home. But there's a verse of scripture that I love about the life of Joseph. The Bible says, and the Lord was with Joseph. Good Lord. I love that verse of scripture. Anything Joseph touched was blessed. There is nothing you can do with a blessed man or a blessed woman. If you curse them, they're already blessed. If you reject them, they're already blessed. Hallelujah. If you hate them, they're already blessed. Hallelujah. Come on. Can I talk to some blessed people here? Hallelujah. Why are you worried what the devil is trying to throw at you? God said it.
Hallelujah.
Why did God have to take him to Egypt and bring him out? when Mrs. Potiphar saw him.
Beauty.
Potiphar saw him. He realized everything Joseph touched. Good God. The name is growing. Good God. Sheep having twin and triplets. He can understand. He called him Ella McLean and said, I'm going to make you the head. That's why I tell folks they don't have to fight for nothing. I don't know why folks fight for things in church. Come on, talk to me, somebody. Touch your brother and sister, say, don't fight. If you fight, you disqualify yourself. Come on, what's yours, Pastor Jacob, will be yours. Come on, you don't have to fight for nothing. Come on, sit in church and praise God. Do I have some worshipers in here? Hallelujah! Because there's some folks become evangelists and elders and don't worship anymore. They just wave hands. The devil is a lie. Has always been a lie. We are called to be to the praise of His glory. Before I was an elder, I was a worshiper. Before I was a teacher, I was a worshiper. Before I was a preacher, I was a worshiper. rejoicing. Come on. Folks want position. And they have no misery. You're going to go through some misery to get ministry. Hallelujah. Come on, talk to me, somebody. Hello, somebody. Hallelujah. You want ministry. You want anointing. Come on, you're going to be crushed. You're going to be walked on. You're going to be humiliated. And how you react to your adversity will determine whether or not you will be promoted. Come on, you can't have revival until you know how to react. Somebody say suffer. Have you proof? Potiphar recognized the blessing.
Take your time.
Potiphar recognized that this young man is different. This Egyptian heathen recognized that Joseph has something, an aura. Every person has an aura. You travel with an atmosphere. You ever see some people bitter? As soon as you talk to them, bitterness comes out of them. That's the aura they walk with. You don't want to connect yourself to people like those because they're going to define your spirit. That's the atmosphere they live under, sleep with, wake up with. Come on, brothers and sisters. Young man, I'm going to promote you. Joseph didn't ask for promotion. Hello? Come on, talk to me, somebody. Folks are putting their requisition now for promotion. I think it's time for me to be promoted from a deacon to an elder. Disqualify. You disqualify yourself when you beg for it. It was Potiphar who saw the blessing on Joseph that gave him a calling and said, I'm going to promote you.
Bless the Lord,
and he made him head over his whole house.